Hi guys! Welcome sa Engineered Math Channel. Sa video na to ay tuturo ko sa inyo ang related rates. So kung gusto niyo itong matutunan, just keep on watching. Okay, so this time ay tuturo ko naman sa inyo yung isang application ng differential calculus, which is yung related rates. So, itong related rates or time rates ay parang application siya ng implicit differentiation. Kasi, gagamit tayo ng implicit differentiation, i-derivative natin yung nabuo nating equation with respect to a variable t, which is time. Kasi related rates. Yung rate of change ng isang bagay na related sa rate of change din ng another bagay based on an equation that is representing their relationship. Yung mga variables na to. So, meron tayong iba't ibang steps para makapag-solve ng related rates. So, first one, we have draw a diagram if necessary, label constants with their numerical value. So, mahalaga na i-draw natin yung diagram kasi dun tayo kukuha ng ating magiging equation. Okay? Two, determine which weights are given and which weight you need to find. So, dun sa problem, sasabihin naman sa inyo kung ano yung rate na given at anong rate yung hahanapin. So, after nyo madrawing, then pwede nyo nang i-take note kung ano-ano yung mga given at ano yung mga hahanapin na rates. Okay? Then, three, find an equation relating the variables defined in step one. Okay, so after nyo madrawing, syempre, ma-analyze nyo na yung problem, then makakabuo kayo ng equation. Kasi yung equation na yun, yung gagamitin nyo para makuha nyo yung related rates ng different variables. Okay? Four, differentiate equation in step three. So after nyo makuha yung equation na yun, i-derivative nyo yun both sides with respect to time. Or with respect to a variable t, which is time. Kasi nga, related rates. Okay? Then, 5. Substitute all the given information into the result of step 4 and find the unknown rate. So, after nyo makuha yung derivative, makakaroon kayo ng parang differential equations doon. Then, substitute nyo lahat ng mga given na nilist nyo dito sa 2 doon sa nabuo nyong equation. Then, tsaka nyo na pwedeng masolve yung unknown rates na pinapahanap. Okay? So, para ma-illustrate kung paano mag-solve ng related rates problem, ay mag-solve tayo ng examples. So, solve the following related rates problems. Number one, we have a ladder 25 feet long is leaning against a vertical wall if the bottom of the ladder is pulled horizontally away from the wall at 3 feet per second. How fast is the top of the ladder sliding down the wall when the bottom is 15 feet from the wall? Okay, so yung famous problem sa related rates, yung ladder problem. So sabi, draw muna natin para ma-analyze natin kung ano ba yung magiging equation. Okay, so meron daw tayong ladder, which is yung length niya is 25 feet. Tapos, nakalin siya sa wall. So let's say ito yung wall, okay? Tapos ito yung ground. So nag-i-slide down daw yung ladder na to, like this. And then, pababa ng pababa siya. Tapos, yung rate down, nung pag-slide down niya dito sa floor is 3 feet per second. So, pinangalanan ko itong wall as y feet and then itong ground is x feet. Yung x is the distance noong bottom part ng ladder to the wall. Okay, so merong rate of change nitong x. So, dx over dt is given by 3 feet per second. Tapos, ano pang given? Kapag daw itong distance na to na x is 15 feet, ano raw yung magiging rate or yung pinapahanap bali is dy over dt, right? Yung vertical change naman nung pagbaba nitong top ng ladder doon sa wall with respect to time. So, dy over dt yung hinahanap. Okay, so after nating masulat yung mga given, so meron tayong mga given, yung 25 constant, tapos, dx over dt yung rate. Tapos, ito yung condition daw. When x is equal to 15 feet, find dy over dt. Kailangan nating bumuo ng equation. So, mapapansin nyo, ano yung nabuo nating figure? Itong wall, itong ladder, tsaka itong ground, ay nakabuo tayo ng right triangle. So, pwede tayong gumamit ng Pythagorean theorem, right? X squared plus y squared is equal to, yung hypotenuse natin, is yung length ng ladder na 25. So, 25 squared. Sum of the squares of the legs is equal to the square of the hypotenuse. So, we have x squared plus y squared is equal to 25 squared is 625. Now, next step daw, after natin makuha yung equation, is the derivative natin both sides of the equation with respect to t. So, dahil ang variable natin ay x saka y at hindi t, dapat maglalagay tayo ng dx over dt and dy over dt after natin silang maderivative using implicit differentiation, right? So, pag derivative natin itong x squared plus y squared, yung x squared is power rule 2x and then dapat may dx over dt. Then plus, si y squared is 2y, then dapat may dy over dt. Implicit differentiation. Equals, so derivative ng 625 which is constant is just 0. So, pwede nating masolve si dy over dt by, so transpose ko tong 2x dx over dt dito sa right. So, magiging 2y times dy over dt is equal to negative 2x dx over dt. So, pwede nating makancel si 2, right? So, magiging y dy over dt is equal to negative x dx over dt. So, ang gusto natin is dy over dt kasi yan yung pinapahanap. So, divide natin both sides by y. So, makakancel si y, matitira si dy over dt equal to negative x dx over dt over y or negative x over y na lang. So, ngayon, dahil meron naman tayong dx over dt tsaka yung x, ano na lang kulang natin? Itong y. So, para masolve si y, apply natin yung Pythagorean theorem. So, diba ito yung nabuo nating equation? So, substitute natin itong x na 15 feet dito sa equation natin, then solve for y. Para yun yung ipa-plug in natin dito sa formula. So, we have, so x is 15. So, 15 square plus y square is equal to 625. So, 15 square is what? 225 plus y square equals 625. So, transpose si 225, we have y squared is equal to 625 minus 225. So, 625 minus 225 is what? 400. Then, para masolve si y, square root natin both sides, we have y is equal to square root of 400 or simply 20. So, ngayon, meron na tayo lahat ng value. So, si x nga is 15, so we have negative 15 over yung y na nasolve natin, 20, times dx over dt na given na 3 feet per second. Okay? So, ilan to? Negative 15 times 3 divided by 20. Negative 9 over 4 feet per second. So, therefore, yung rate nung pag-slide down nung top part nung ating ladder when x is equal to 15 feet, given na yung dx over dt is 3 feet per second, is negative 9 over 4 feet per second. So, negative siya kasi mapapansin nyo, palit ng palit yung distance, right? So, kaya pa negative yung kanyang rate. Okay? Next, we have, a tank is in the form of an inverted cone having an altitude of 16 meters and radius of 4 meters. Water is flowing into the tank at the rate of 2 cubic meter per minute. How fast is the water level rising when the water is 5 meters deep? Okay, so sige, draw muna natin para ma-visualize natin. Okay, so meron daw tayong inverted cone. So, ito yon, nakabaliktad, na merong altitude na 16 meters. So, ito siya, 16 meters. And then, meron siyang radius na 4 meters. So, ito yon. Tapos, water is flowing into the tank at the rate of 2 cubic meters per minute. So, cubic meters, ibig sabihin volume. Ibig sabihin, may binubuhos daw dito na tubig. Tapos, yung rate of change ng pagbuhos is 2 cubic meters per minute. So, parang dv over dt yon, right? With respect to time. Tapos, ang tanong, how fast is the water level rising when the water is 5 meters deep? So, yung keyword is how fast daw the water is rising. So, di ba kapag rising, height yon. So, pinapahanap is itong rate of change nung h or height with respect to time. Kapag daw yung water, so ito, let's say, h is 5 meters deep. Okay? So, next step, after nating ma-analyze is makakabuo dapat tayo ng equation. So, dahil meron tayong rate of change of volume, dapat alam natin yung formula for the volume nung cone. So, di ba alam naman natin yun sa ating solid geometry na formula ng volume ng cone is 1/3 pi r squared h. Okay? So, mapapansin nyo, wala tayong rate of change for the radius. Right? Wala tayong given. Ang given lang natin is itong dv over dt. Tapos, yung pinapahanap is itong h lang. So, concern lang tayo sa h. So, kapag ganun, kapag meron tayong more than one variable, tapos yung isang variable doon is walang given rate of change, dapat mag-iisip tayo ng way para ma-solve yung isang variable na yon, in this case r, in terms of the other variable na concern tayo sa h, right? So, ano sa tingin yung pwede natin gamitin para ma-solve natin yung r in terms of h? Makuha natin yung relationship. Kung mapapansin nyo, pwede tayong kumuha ng cross-section na to, right? Which is a right triangle. Tapos, kung i-consider natin itong portion na to, itong r, tsaka itong h na to, pwede tayong makabuo ng dalawang similar triangle. Itong triangle na to, tapos itong malaking triangle na to, by AA similarity theorem. So, itong kabuang height na to is itong given na 16, tapos itong kabuang radius na to, ang given is 4. So, pwede tayong kumuha ng proportion. So, yung ratio nitong 16 by 4 is dapat equal sa ratio nitong, okay, itong height na to is h, right? Itong smaller height. Ratio din dapat ng height to radius na maliit. So, h over r. So, we have 16 divided by 4 is 4 equals h over r. So, solving for r in terms of h, so cross-multiply ko na lang si r sa taas tapos si 4 sa baba. So, parang r is equal to 1/4 h. Okay? And then, substitute natin itong r in terms of h sa formula ng volume. So, v is equal to 1/3 pi r is 1/4 times h squared times h. So, simplify natin. Volume is equal to 1/3 pi. So, distribute natin itong exponent. Magiging h squared over 4 squared or 16 times h. So, v is equal to, sa constant, we have pi over 3 times 16 is pi over 48. And then, h squared times h is h cubed. So, in terms na lang yung volume of h. So, pwede na nating i-differentiate both sides with respect to t using implicit differentiation. So, derivative ng v with respect to t is 1, then dapat may dv over dt equals, so itong pi over 48 is constant, gilid ko lang, differentiate natin itong h cubed with respect to t, we have power formula, 3h square, then dapat may nakamultiply na dh over dt. So, therefore, we have dv over dt equals, so cancel si 3, cancel si 48, magiging 16. We have pi over 16 h square dh over dt. So, ang gusto lang natin is dh over dt. So, pwede natin i-divide both sides by pi over 16 h square para ma-solve si dh over dt. So, therefore, we have cancel dh over dt is what? Dv over dt divided by pi over 16 h square. Or 16 dv over dt over pi h square, right? Dh over dt. So, pwede na nating ma-plug in yung mga given values. So, yung dv over dt is 2. Tapos, yung h is 5. So, we have dh over dt is equal to 16 times dv over dt na 2 over pi times h is 5, so 5 square. So, we have 16 times 2 is 32 over pi times 5 square or 25 pi meter per minute. So, therefore, the answer is 32 over 25 pi meter per minute. Okay? Next, we have air is being pumped into a spherical balloon at a rate of 5 cubic centimeter per minute. Determine the rate at which the radius of the balloon is increasing when the diameter of the balloon is 20 centimeter. Okay, so meron daw tayong, let's say, spherical balloon. Okay, so, nangyari ito siya. Tapos, at the rate of 5 cubic centimeter per minute, air is being pumped. So, may pinapasok na hangin. Okay? Tapos, determine the rate daw at which the radius of the balloon is increasing. So, di ba meron tong radius? So, ano raw yung rate of change ng radius with respect to time kapag daw yung pinapump na air is yung rate nga is, so volume yun kasi cubic centimeter. So dV over dt is 5 cubic centimeter per minute. At dapat daw yung diameter is 20 centimeter. So d is 20 centimeter. So dahil given tayo dun sa rate of change ng volume ng sphere na dV over dt equals 5 cubic centimeter per minute, pwede natin gamitin dito yung volume ng sphere. So using solid geometry formula, the volume of a sphere is what? 4/3 pi r cube, right? So pinapahanap is dr over dt. So since isa lang naman yung variable natin, which is r, pwede natin i-differentiate agad with respect to t itong equation natin. So we have dv over dt is equal to 4/3 pi, so constant, gigilid ko lang. Then, derivative ng r cube is 3r squared. Then, dapat may dr over dt. So, cancel si 3, magiging dv over dt is equal to 4 pi r squared dr over dt. And then, dahil gusto natin si dr over dt, divide natin both sides by 4 pi r squared. So, cancel, we have dr over dt equal to dv over dt divided by 4 pi r squared. So, pwede na nating ma-plug in yung mga given. So, di ba yung dv over dt is 5? Tapos, yung r is add yung given. So, dapat r. So, para makuha yung radius, di ba yung r is equal to diameter over 2 lang. So, divide lang natin tong 20 centimeter by 2, which is 10 centimeter. So, pwede na natin ma-plug in dito sa derived formula. So, dr over dt is dv over dt, which is 5. So, 5 over 4 pi, then times r squared. So, r is 10, right? So, we have 10 squared equals dr over dt. So, simplify natin. 5 over 4 pi. So, 10 squared is 100. So, cancel si 5 sa numerator. Magiging 20 si 100. We have 1 over 4 pi times 20 is 80 pi. So, therefore, dr over dt is 1 over 80 pi. Okay? Okay, so I think that's it for this video, related rates. So, practice lang kayong mag-solve ng related rates problem para ma-master nyo yung topic na to. Okay? So, sana ay may natutunan kayo sa video na to at maraming salamat sa panonood.